Hi guys, this is Livia and you are now watching CGTN's live stream, and this is our special coverage of Along China's Expressway. And we are now here at Lanzhou City, which is also the capital city of Northwest China's Gansu Province. And this is also our first stop of Wuhai-Maqin Expressway.
Yeah, we actually drove all the way here from Ningxia yesterday in Zhongwei, which was quite a long drive, about 3 or 4 hours, but it was really comfortable down the expressway. And we ended at a huge service center just outside of Lanzhou. You can see the vlog tomorrow, don't miss it.
Yeah, don't miss it.
Not tomorrow, actually, later.
Stay tuned with us. Okay, so have you ever been to Lanzhou or Gansu Province?
I've been a lot, actually. I lose count of the amount of times I've been to Lanzhou, because actually, if you travel in northwestern China, a lot of the time you'll stop here or fly through here. Mm-hmm. But I've also been to other places like Dongshan Minority Autonomous County,
yes,
as well as Shandan. Shandan's an amazing place with lots of New Zealand history, actually.
Oh, really?
Mm.
So did you try all the local foods there?
Yeah, I've eaten a lot. In fact, one of my favorite things in Gansu is Gansu potato, which was really good.
That's your favorite, right?
It really is. But also, it seems like every meal they eat lamb, which, while it's delicious, it can be a bit too much.
Yeah, but you know what? Lamb is one of the most popular dish in the northwest regions.
And
in
it's
China.
Really good. Yeah.
But today, I guess you can try another kind of dish with beef in it.
Ah, that sounds refreshing.
Yeah, here we are. So this is like one of the most popular, and it's like the top one, the most recommend one, the Lanzhou beef noodle restaurant.
So it's very famous.
Yeah, we can go inside and
Yeah, let's go in and try it.
Let's go inside and try. This is actually how local people start their day, right? You know what? Most old generations would like to start their day with a bowl of beef noodles.
What about in summer? It's going to be too hot.
Yeah, it's going to be hot, but they love it. They love it.
Wow, it smells amazing.
Yeah.
So I guess normally you would just sit down, but now we can have a look at what they have. Oh, here's the price. It's 10 kuai, which is about $1.60 US for a bowl of beef noodle, and it comes with two small salads. You can choose from here.
You can choose either cucumbers or
potatoes. And then I think the most popular one is 20 kuai, about $3.40, which comes with two salads as well as an egg and some beef.
And you can see the chef.
Look at the beef.
The chef is cutting the beef into slices.
So they really eat hot noodles every morning.
And you know what? The price is very cheap and affordable.
Very affordable.
And you know, some restaurants in Lanzhou even offer some free food, free Lanzhou beef noodles for those cleaners in the city.
So oh, like street cleaners.
That's very thoughtful.
That is awesome.
Yeah, that's very awesome.
But you know what? I want to ask, why do they call it pulled noodles?
Oh, that's a good question. Because the noodles were actually really pulled by chefs.
Oh, like did they pull the
yes,
dough?
Yes, exactly.
Do you think we can try? Maybe?
I think today we can try, and maybe we need to go into the kitchen and find out how the...
Yeah. Let's wear our mask.
So, due to the COVID-19, we have to put on our mask before we enter the kitchen.
And you can see all these people. It's quite early in the morning, about 9:30. And all these people are eating really hot noodles, which is quite interesting for me, because I wouldn't imagine noodles as a morning dish.
But this is how local people start their day. Wow, as you can see.
It's hot in here.
It's hot in the kitchen, a very busy kitchen, you can see.
Whoa, tough work.
It's the lunch time. And as you can see, the chef over there is kneading the dough.
Let's go see if we can introduce ourselves.
Okay.
I want to try it.
您好，师傅，这不方便握手了。您现在做的是什么？我做的是牛肉面，清汤牛肉面啊。
So he's about to prepare for pulling noodles.
那师傅，您可以给我们简单介绍一下您自己吗？我是兰州牛肉面第四代传人，我叫马文斌，我从事这个工作已经有46年了。
He's already been doing this
for 46 years. Yeah, he's like the very famous chef, actually, and he's the fourth generation inheritor of Lanzhou beef noodles. So we're so lucky today to have him to enjoy our live stream.
Yeah.
And Mr. Ma just noticed that he has been working as a chef of Lanzhou beef noodles for over 40 years.
Wow.
So that's a long time. So Shifu now is preparing for some duck.
那这些都是一粉吗？还是？ 都是一份吗？
一份
啊，
这是一份啊，
很多
啊，就是。
我听说兰州牛肉面有很多，比如说有很多不同的洗的不同的宽的什么的。
就是兰州牛肉面，它就是有面型的话是有这个12种。
So there are like 12 different types of noodles.
All different thicknesses and
yeah, wide.
Thinness.
And wide.
哪一种是最受欢迎的？
这个的话是根据这个不同的年龄，不同各自的嗜好，有老年人喜欢吃毛细、韭叶、细的这一类的，年轻人吃上二细、大块，他表示他自己年轻嘛，体力茂壮嘛，威猛嘛，阳光嘛。
对对对。
So Shifu just said like different groups of people they would like to order different types of noodles actually.
Including older people like to eat the most thin, which is called care thin noodle, and I think he's going to show us how to do that.
Yeah, and young generations prefer the kind of like the belt noodles.
They're stronger.
Yeah, because they're stronger. Yeah, actually. And now, 师傅，您可以给我们看一下，就是怎么样去拉一个面吗？您表演一下。
不是，我在拉这是兰州牛肉面，它却其实说简单也不简单。
不简单。
它的主要讲究是三遍水、三遍灰、9981遍揉。做好一碗好的牛肉面，不仅仅是9981遍揉，要反复的揉，揉了最后有面这个起泡了，有光泽，有润滑度。
So it's not easy.
So it looks like very easy, but Lanzhou beef noodles is not that easy. It's very difficult.
You've got to pay attention to a lot of different
aspects.
Strict
procedures. So here we go.
So this is why they call it pulled noodles.
So now for those who are watching this live stream, we're now at Lanzhou City, and this is... we are now in the kitchen of Lanzhou Beef Noodles Restaurant.
He's a fourth generation inheritor of the cultural legacy of Lanzhou Beef Noodles. Wow, 很棒.
As you can see, this is the 毛细, as we call it. And this kind of noodle is like thin as hair.
它的细就是顶我住处叙述发丝。然后你头发丝有多细它就有多细。这适合表这个年龄。比较就是个70-80岁这的牙齿没有了，他这个吃的话就是长寿面，也就老人喜欢吃，吃上他也感觉到心里面非常高兴，他自己就是说健康长寿嘛。
So that like for those old generations, especially for those in their 70s or 80s, it's easy for them to chew.
So they like to eat the most thin type here.
Yes. So Annie, do you want to try it?
对，我想试试看，可以。
好，可以。
可以试一下吗？Okay.
我觉得我们一定会失败。
I'm really looking forward to it, actually.
Yeah, let's wear an apron.
Yeah, I think we need to put on the opera.
慢慢的话就是锻炼的话就是了，辛苦三次了，第一次吃好了。慢慢的，就是拉就多好了。你看，现在的话，
我们要先洗手吗？
洗个手。这
里面
洗个手
啊。师傅您在这儿等我们，让他去洗个手。
我快去洗个手。
你不做了吗？
我一会儿做。
不用，
站着。And
then. 我现在就过去
拿
一个嘛。好了啊。现在你看。
I'm really looking forward to it. I think Eddie, you're gonna.
I'm gonna fail. I think.
You're gonna succeed.
我现在的话先拉一个，
但是我们做的不是这种嘛，这是最难做的是吧？
就我现在拉一个，的话手法拉一下，你们看一下，
然
后大家一起
做，可以，
好吗
？So we're gonna watch him first and then see if we can try.
你看，这样看，这个穿过来，润到这，再继续再拉，反复拉，或者再提一下，这样反复的拉，反复的拉。
I'm going to try it a couple of times.
这样的话就可以就撑起来了。
Well, it looks easy, but 这是细的是吧？
细的。
So this is like the other type of noodles. It's called 细的。
Okay.
细的 is like thin as pencil lead.
Now, don't forget, you guys, that he's been doing this for 40 years, so don't laugh at me.
So this is the first time for Andy to do it, so let's watch.
再拉一下，再拉一下，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉，再拉
这样一顿，OK，那这是最宽的吧？这是最粗的，这是最粗的，满意做啊。OK，一定不要把这些给顾客啊。啊，不可能。但是我跟你说，我自己还是觉得这看起来很好吃啊，
就是，嗯，也都可以，这是自己亲手做的嘛，嗯，心里感觉也是就可以了，嗯，但是我还要问一下。
这一部分都是浪费的吗？这一部分不是浪费的，就完了以后再揉起来再那个，它因为它不这样的话，它这个面条拉不匀了。So
I just asked him if this part here would be thrown away, but he said these pieces can be used to put together with other pieces and come together to use it again. And I also said, even though I failed with my noodle making, I still think it looks quite delicious.
It looks quite delicious and almost.
Almost edible.
Yeah, almost.
I can pretend it's
my
own. Oh.
So, Olivia,
you want to try? Good job, Andy.
Okay, this is the one I did. Very good. Now, can I work here? Can. Thank you.
As long as you have the right
to work. Yes, you can
learn it in the morning. If you are comfortable, anyone can
learn it. So this kind of job is all about hardworking.
手感也挺好的。就是，它这个面团揉好了以后，它就是这个手感就是比较好。你但是为什么说三遍水三遍灰呢？你这个面团和不好，三遍水的话，它就这个面和着不伤水；不伤水的话，它就这个的话，
不会有这个感觉，不粘手。啊。Just
like what Shifu
said，方子做好了，所以之后手感也好。
So it's like Shifu said, they add some special plants into it. They add penghui. It's a very local.
Alkaline. 水烧成水之后注水以后，再然后就埋起来，等到第二天、第三天冷却了以后，那个一块大块的那石头块，它那块就像那个石磨的那块一样的，就那么大的块，然后把那个挖出来之后就是砸成小块，砸成小块之后来就砸成这豆瓣这么大的，开始在锅里面煮。
So the easiest translation is it's very difficult, very specialized process. It looks easy, but 因为我刚刚想问你，这个只有不是只有面粉和水，还有很多东西。铜灰
is one of the important ingredients.
面粉和水、铜灰，就这三样东西。
但是做法都不一样。That's a secret why the noodles are so soft.
清油它就起了一个不粘连的作用，不粘的作用。And
also put a layer of oil to make it separate with different dots.
啊，挺有意思的。好，
那师傅，您可以给我们看一下其他几种面是怎么拉的，可以吗？我听说有很多不同种的面。对。今天给大家现场拉八种。 Oh, they're going to perform like eight types of noodles.
Okay, now the eight types are relate to, the noodle is the same, but the eight types relate to the thickness. So there's
wide and very thin. 它全长256根,384米, 它的一根接起来之后的话, 相当于130层楼房的高度。
So Shifu just said he's going to perform how to pull Mao Xi, like thinnest hair. And it's like over 20 slices of noodles. Yeah. And the length can be like over 300 meters.
Wow. 拧做得很快。
就是，这个是什么？这个我捞一个细的，就是一个大众化的面食，就是普通人都喜欢，因为那个太毛细，它就压里面嚼起来没有这个筋道。细的话，它有一个筋道，也就是适合这个中年人或者女同志他们吃，就一个细的。
So this is seed. Seed is like thin as pencil
length.
Yeah, it's very common for the most young generations, especially the female consumers.
那我想问一下，如果一个老外来兰州，但是他不知道要他要哪一种，你会推荐哪一种？第一次吃兰州牛肉面的？那是我就喜欢这个，他推荐这个细的，就是最受欢迎的一种面食。
So this is a seed is actually one of the most popular type of noodles.
Yeah, if somebody comes to Lanzhou,
like 九叶就是这个party里面。 最少的一种，它也就是说，新式蔬菜的韭菜叶一样，它的每个截面是0.5公分，它是就是和这个拉好以后称好以后和这个机器面相媲美。Okay,
so now Shifu is going to perform how to pull 九叶, which is like the width of it is like wide as chives.
Wide as chives.
Yeah.
它也就是形容就是这个手工拉制的机器面一样，下面我再拉一个这个，三细。三细。The
third level of thinness.
这个宽度大概是多少？这个宽度没量啊，这个。 三细是吧？三细 I think it's like
about 4 millimeters.
Yeah, maybe four millimeters.
这个细点稍微粗一点，这就是就可以，就是嚼到嘴里面的话，它有这个韧性了。It's
chewable.
然后的话是下一个这个二细，二细比这个三细的话更粗一点。
Thicker a little bit.
Very
popular.
This is 三细, and this is 二细.
体的帽状嘛，表示他吃二细的话，他你看阳刚嘛，我吃的二细，你吃的毛细，他也可以种。
Most young people prefer this one.
下面我下一个这个小宽。 小宽，这个小宽是这个，哦，这个就很宽。它这个撑起来的话是，也就是说，这个，好像是这个，五彩缤纷，彩带飞翔，也就是一个一个，你看这个，抡起来这个像，哇，像个彩带一样，
好漂亮啊！
It's like a beautiful belt, colorful belt, as he described it.
就是它这个，像两个手指一样粗是吗？一个手指。它是这个是，1.5公分。1.5公分。它比这个要这个0.5，这个1.5。
So now we're going to see the last. No, second to last.
这以后我给下一个这个荞麦轮，荞麦轮它就是一个。
This is one of the very special types of noodles.
Triangle?
Triangle one. And this is like, I think the... 您是唯一一个会拉荞麦轮的吗？不，现在都教的基本上都会了。你看。
This is the triangle
shape. Ma is the master of pulling 荞麦轮, which is like the triangle shape of
noodles. It's a triangle shape of noodles. 这个面条六手成型，你看，哇，这个很特别。它那60成型的荞麦呢，它有棱有角，都是一个三角形，就像那个军人的那刺刀一样。This
one is very special. It's like every angle is you can look like it.
Every angle is a triangle.
Yeah, it's triangle.
最后的对吧？
下面我就给大家下一个大宽。
可以。
大宽。
the most thick or wide type. It's kind of like a belt.
大块，我们这个兰州的土话也就是说是把这皮带面。 就是说你的这个系的这个腰带有多宽？哦，腰带。So
it is just like a belt.
它就有多宽？所以你还可以叫它腰带面嘛？它就是个这么描述的。看你就这么宽啊。这个拉起来以后，拉高以后，下到锅里面以后，煮出来。哦，做法还是不一样。灯光上去照的话，它两边卷起来，像那个海带海里面的海带一样。哦，我知道
seaweed.
它起出来之后就好吃，我住这么多，卷的啊。It's really wide, like belt. 你看它就是这么宽，真的是腰带。It's really like a belt. 它也和这个陕西的这个表面面比它的那还要宽一点。啊。So
they have a thicker one in Shanxi province.
还有一个就是二柱子，二柱子适合就是说是正是这个非常就是这个胃口好的这个人吃的。 它那个吃的比较粗，二柱子的话，它有很粗很粗的。
In Chinese, it's called 二柱子. And it's between the thin and white type.
它就是也形容是这个鸡肠子，就说鸡的那个肠子一样的，它就是拉之后的拌上以后的话，它看起来这个的话，这个面条的话，它非常。 有韧性，煮好以后韧有韧性，有嚼头，这几个面条都适合这个年轻气盛的二十几岁的小。
Yeah, so for young people, they most of the time they choose 二柱子 or 三C or 二C.
是不是因为我感觉看这个的话，这个最细的有可能会更吸那个辣味儿嘛？
就那基本上都一样。哦，都一样。它就是不同的年龄段，不同的这个爱好。
根据自己的这个，因为他们的牙齿有可能不好，不吃这个。
但面条的话是就是基本上是就是八种，但是我们挑战了上海吉尼斯世界纪录的话，是我们用这个12种面型挑战成功。
So most of chefs can pull like eight types.
宽的这个小宽比这个小宽里头宽的一种中宽，它还有一个这个宽酒叶，还有一个这个大宽里面比大宽还宽的一种。 叫个胖宽带，
所以师傅您是会拉12种是吗？我觉得都会拉。 Yeah, so most chefs can pull like eight types of noodles, and Mr. Ma can pull like 12 different kinds of it. Yeah, 那 Andy, 你如果想吃哪几种呢?
If I chose one to eat today, probably I would be more interested to try this one, the belt noodle.
The belt noodle?
Because it just looks really soft and juicy.
Yes, and then maybe I would like to try the thinnest
one. 哦,我天哪!
Oh, so this one is...
这个很像那种意大利面的那种。
意大利面，我们也在意大利面，和这个在意大利去和这个意大利面也劈开做了一次。意大利面它是纯机器做的。它是机器面，它是机器面。Italian
noodles are from a machine, not from hand.
So Italian noodles is actually all for by machine, but this is actually all by hand.
哦，对，意大利面就是那种。
Yeah.
So, 师傅，那您能不能给我们下几碗面，让我们试吃一下呢？
好，我下一个。
来，您下几碗面，让我们试吃一下，so we can try the
food. Sure. Did you see all the beef here? Yes. This is actually for the soup.
The broth. The Lanzhou beef noodle broth is also very important. So, you don't just pay attention to the type of noodle, but also the broth.
So, 师傅 is about to prepare a bowl of beef noodles for us.
Whoa. Okay, I'm gonna read some comments from online. If you guys are just tuning in, we're watching the making of Lanzhou beef noodles, which are very, very famous. Okay, we have a comment from April Wong, who says she really wishes she could try it out too. Yeah, it is really fun. Dusty says real noodles and no plastic, right? You can see here it's all totally natural, amazing, and tasty.
And a comment from a YouTube user called Fox Hon, and he said, "Here I am watching this while eating instant noodles."
Okay, let's go out.
So our dish is ready. This is beautiful. Wow, I really feel like this is a very busy kitchen, and everyone is busy and prepare all the dishes for the local people.
Yeah.
As you can see over here, many people are still having their
breakfast.
Yeah,
it's really cool. Hey, I got one more comment. Carazon says, he's a real expert making noodles without a machine. I agree.
Yeah, I agree too. Wow, so seems like our dishes are ready.
Wow,
厨房里真的很热，很荣幸能够跟你一起吃。
可以把口罩拿掉。所以我们这里有几种？有12种，它这个前面的这些。这个牛肉面它有一定的讲究，它就是选的，我们这选的就是海拔3000多米高的那个高原上的那个牦牛肉。 牦牛它也是在这个牛肉的这个品种里面，它是一个最好的一个品种。还有就是它的肉质比较细嫩，爽口。So
they choose the best type of beef. Like they lay like over 3,000 above the sea level, meters above the sea level.
Wow.
And also today we now, so our dishes are ready. And 师傅，您可以介绍一下我们今天点的这些都是什么？准备吃啥？准备吃啥呢？牛肉面。
它也就是说是讲究点，也就是一清二白三红四绿五黄，一清就是。这个太复杂了，是什么意思？我不懂。一清二白三红四绿，这是关于糖是吧？So
it's all about the five major key features of a great bowl of beef noodles. So maybe we can ask him what color means, right?
The five different colors. What is the meaning?
一清就指的是汤清，牛肉面的这个汤清。
So the first one
必须要是清的。
The first one is that the soup is very clean.
Clear.
Yeah.
二白，它就指的这个萝卜片白。
So the second major key the reddish, the white reddish.
三黄指的是就是辣椒油魂，所以the third one, third key feature is the red, the chili pepper。四绿就指的这个香菜蒜苗绿，红，green, Chinese, chives，它就是这个面条烹烩，它就是一种盐碱的，就是原始碱，它加到面里面以后，它就微微的带一点黄。 面条本身是白的嘛，它再加一点就像黄了，所以必须要大颜色。它就是这个牛肉面的这个造型的话，它就是一清二白三红四绿五黄。我已经关掉了。
I forgot already. It's too complicated.
Actually, the huang is like the noodle is pretty bright and yellow. The color is good. So maybe we can try. So this one, 这个师傅，这个是毛细。
毛细啊，这适合老年人吃。
Old people prefer to eat this kind.
Yeah, we just trying to pull it.
这个是细的，这个你吃这个就可以。这是最受欢迎的那种。这是最受欢迎的这个。
This is the most popular type here.
你吃这个。我吃这个。你吃这个。
师傅 let me to eat this one.
He's saying you're not old.
Because I'm young, right?
是这个面条起来以后，你看，它是比较就是筋道，也比较细润，爽滑。 顺口啊，顺口啊，你这吃的是大宽，就是大宽的，哎，你看这个炖起来这个叫海带叶一样，见了吧？两边卷起来，中间厚，两边薄，啊，它就那煮好以后它就是发亮的，你看，那海带叶是怎么提起来？啊，对，就是。
You do lift seaweed up like this too.
师傅，那您是哪一种？这个是啊，就这种啊，这是三九叶啊。
The thickness of chives.
九叶，它就新四蔬菜的韭菜叶，它也就是手工拉制的一个机器面一样，它的这个要求很高，尤其它的这横截面必须0.5公分。那我想问您，因为你是非常专业的，那你平时也会去其他的店吃他们的兰州牛肉面吗？还是？也可以吃。
但是受不了。受不了，因为这个的话是就是大家有自己家的这个作坊的这个配料。So
like different chefs, they have different styles of making the Lanzhou beef noodles.
Yeah, I asked him, because he's such a master, does he also eat other people's Lanzhou beef noodles? He said he really doesn't like to, but he does to try it.
Yeah, and different chefs have different recipes for the
对, different
recipes,但是你还是很有名,大家都知道你是很专业。我们这牛肉面是发展就在这个清末民初,也就是在这个1915年左右,是一个回族老人,马宝子老先生创制的。
So he's talking about the history of Lanzhou beef noodles. It actually originated, like we can trace it back to the Qing dynasty. Mm. It started from
我们这牛肉面是发展就在这个清末民初，也就是在这个1915年左右，是一个回族老人马宝子老先生创制的。So he's talking about the history of Lanzhou beef noodles. It actually originated, like we can trace it back to the Qing dynasty. It started from 1918年左右，是一个回族老人马宝子老先生创制的。So he's talking about the history of Lanzhou beef noodles. It actually originated, like we can trace it back to the Qing dynasty. It started from 1918年左右，是一个回族老人马宝子老先生创制的。So he's talking about the history of Lanzhou beef noodles. It actually originated, like we can trace it back to the Qing dynasty. It started from 1918年左右，是一个回族老人马宝子老先生创制的。So he's talking about the history of Lanzhou beef noodles. It actually originated, like we can trace it back to the Qing dynasty. It started from 1918年左右，是一个回族老人马宝子老先生创制的。So he's talking about the history of Lanzhou beef noodles. It actually originated, like we can trace it back to the Qing dyn 了。啊，这个牛肉面也是几百年的历史，就在这汉堡的话是就是把我们这个兰州的这个地道的这个民族产业文化的话是展现给了就是这个汉堡的这些。
So I asked him if you can buy Lanzhou beef noodles overseas, because actually you can't just open a Lanzhou beef noodle store. You have to apply, you have to follow the proper processes. It's very stringent. So China has 40,000 Lanzhou beef noodle stores. Mm-hmm. And you can also buy Lanzhou beef noodles at more than 40 countries.
Yeah, more than 40 countries and regions around the world. Whoa. And they have like over 160 restaurants around the world.
新西兰有吗？
Yeah,
新西兰也有。
Andy is from New Zealand.
New Zealand has some. 你知道哪一个城市吗？
哎呀，哪一个城市我也不太清楚，因为我这个教过的学生也太多了。
啊，对对，
我总共教过的学生也多下有两三千人了。啊，他们都学会之后，各自各自的话就在这个外面的话，也就是创业去了。嗯，
啊，
所以我这个的话是就是说是在这个新西兰。和这个澳大利亚啊，这个日本啊，这个美国啊，这个中东这些国家，基本上都是知道的，基本上都有了。啊，
那很有名。
So Mr. Ma just talked about how he because he's in like the fourth generation of inheritor of Lanzhou beef noodles, and this is a very rare cultural treasure.
Heritage,
of Lanzhou City and Gansu Province. And Mr. Ma is dedicated into influence more people, and he has over 2,000 students all around the world. Mm. So that's a very great thing, you know. That's why you can eat Lanzhou beef noodles in over 40 different countries and regions.
Yeah, so let's ask the audience, have you guys eaten Lanzhou beef noodles before? Post a comment, we should try.
Yeah, I think we should try it. And also, I'm going to remind you that Mr. Ma also has dedicated to developing the Lanzhou beef noodles. And he, under the Belt and Road Initiative, Mr. Ma also traveled to Germany as well. And he has a competition with the German side and to compare their noodles with the European countries and even the noodles from Lanzhou City. Mm. So I think somehow the East and West meet up together because of their cultural history
and connections.
And connections. Mm. And that's very amazing, right? So Annie, maybe it's time for us to eat
对,
our...
所以这个牛肉我们是放进去吗?
放进去。
Ah, we put this beef inside the soup to heat it up, because it's cold.
我们曾经在德国和意大利做的时候,意大利和德国的就是这些... 客人的话是就是吃了以后之后看了以后现场看了以后我们在现场制作的他一锅之后这不是一碗面条是简直是在魔术是在就是做艺术品做艺术品做魔术一样的说是对一团面就是自己撑几下之后马上就变成了一碗面条他们就吃起来之后就感觉到就是非常的 高兴的话,
So
like Mr. Ma said, like he went to Italy and also Germany and all the chefs from the European countries and said, this is a magic because you
like
cannot,
a piece of art.
Yeah, you cannot believe that you can turn a dove like
a slob of dough
into like over like 12 different types of noodles and that's amazing. It's like a magic and piece of art.That's so amazing.
我曾经做的这个面条的话是就是这个视频的话是也在这个纽约时代广场展示过我们兰州牛肉面。
Times Square.
对。那师傅您对这个兰州牛肉面的未来有没有什么希望或者寄予我们就是说也就是说在这我们也劳碌师傅们的依循下。
我们就是说是把希望把我们的这个民族产业文化做大做强就是说走那时候就说是走向全国走向世界但是现在的话是已经都就是全国已经普遍了国门也已经出了在我们这有生之年的话我就把我们这个牛肉面再进一步的做大做强做细做劲做到之后最后的话做成一碗就是面宴一样的
We already see it, right? The bright future of Lanzhou.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
I have a comment from a viewer online. Giovanni said they believe Marco Polo stole the recipe and took it to Italy.
Maybe.
Maybe.
但是这个我觉得挺好吃的, it's really good, yeah.
这个牙齿好的人这个吃起来就很好,这个的话爽苦。师傅,那你以前学这个面的时候也很辛苦吧?我学这个面的时候也就是在这个18岁以前的时候就学的,我们这就是75年的时候我就参加工作,那时候我们的话是就是观音企业,在那边的话跟上我们这个 马宝子老先生的这个儿子马杰森老先生的徒弟，这是也就是传承弟子，我从他的手里面就是学习的。那时候学习的话是也就是学徒的话也就是三年了，不容易。这个的话是就是光这个揉这个面条的话的揉三年才能这个的话是。So
like a bowl of beef noodles is all about hard work. So Mr. Ma started to learn make Lanzhou beef noodles since like in his 18 years old, and he has practiced for like over 40 years. So it's all about hard work, and also while you are eating a bowl of beef noodles, don't forget about all the chefs
behind it, and
don't forget about their efforts and their dedications and their love for the Lanzhou beef noodles. So, 师傅，那我们一起吃吧。
我们一起吧，我们一起吧。你吃过了啊？你吃过了。我再吃。我还想问你，你每天吃兰州牛肉面，每天都吃。我是本身做一项工作，你就必须要爱这一行。你不爱这一行，你就做不出来一碗好的面。啊，It's true。所以这个的话是从进这个店的话，就开始去学习的话，就是爱上这一行。所以这个的话是师傅们说的话，你不爱这一行，你就做不出来一碗好的面。
很有道理，反复的去研究琢磨，做好怎么做好，怎么做精，怎么做细，
就是说是自己吃到感觉到，就说是很好了，就说大家顾客的话是就是非常受欢迎的，啊。
So it's like, it's not about what kind of job you are doing, it's all about your loving and your passion and heart into this business. Whatever business you are doing right now, please remember what Mr. Ma just said. You can become a master if you pay attention to it and pay much more effort into it. Okay, so now we're going to try the noodles over here, and thanks for watching our live stream. And
if you guys want to keep watching,
and we really enjoy our experience today with Mr. Ma, who is the fourth generation inheritor of Lanzhou beef noodles, and we're so happy to have him together with us today. So if you want to eat very authentic Lanzhou beef noodles, please do come to Lanzhou City, and I think Mr. Ma will be so happy
waiting
to welcome
with open arms.
All of you from home and abroad. So thank you so much, and stay tuned for our live streaming in the following 4 days along the Wuhai-Maqin Expressway.
See you guys later.
See you later.
Bye-bye.
And we'll have our breakfast.
我们继续吃吧。
谢谢你。挺好的。
这个挺好吃的。
挺好吃。